बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन. माय नेम इज़ तहरीन फातिमा एंड माय प्रोग्राम इज बीएस फिजिक्स. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव अ प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन द टॉपिक एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ यूवी विजिबल स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी. एज आई एम इट्स द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द प्रेजेंटेशन, सो माय फेलोज हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड यूवी विजिबल स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन, द वर्किंग एंड कैरेक्टराइजेशन. सो आई एम एंडिंग द टॉपिक विद गिविंग द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ यूवी विजिबल स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी. सो इन कॉन्टेंट्स आई गिव द ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ केमिस्ट्री एंड एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ केमिस्ट्री इन एवरी डे लाइफ, एंड देन द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ यूवी विजिबल स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी, एंड देन आई एक्सप्लेन फ्यू एप्लीकेशंस इन डिटेल. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, chemistry touches so many aspects of our lives that you are guaranteed to find chemistry at the forefront of many advances and developments. Chemistry as a science that is so universally applicable has fields of study that are all over the map. These desperate studies in chemistry mean that researchers and chemists could be working in industries just as varied, but there are some shared techniques and technologies used by researchers and industrialists that span the chemistry gamut. So when it comes to UV visible spectroscopy, it is one of the common tools in many chemists' toolbox. This versatile measurement technique has a secure place in the chemistry lab. So spectroscopy is the measurement and interpretation of electromagnetic radiations absorbed or emitted when the molecules or atoms or ions of a sample move from one energy state to another energy state. UV spectroscopy is a type of absorption spectroscopy in which light of ultraviolet region is absorbed by the molecule, which results in the excitation of the electrons from the ground state to the high energy state. So in this slide, I just give an overview of UV visible spectroscopy application in different fields of life, which can be traditional chemistry, life science, microbiology, food and agriculture, material science, optical components, pharmaceutical research. And UV visible have so much application in pharmaceutical research and petrochemistry as well, cosmetic industry, which I have explained in the next slides, and quality control of the products. So the first application comes under the fixed wavelength. Fixed wavelength measurement is the simplest application of a spectrometer. It is a single or multiplier wavelength measurement, and as for all other measurement types, the result can be reported in absorbance or transmittance. Further calculation can be done to obtain the final result, for example, a concentration of a substance. So we use fixed wavelength application in chemical industry. So UV absorption spectroscopy is one of the best methods for the determination of the purity of organic solutions. Additional peaks appearing at specific wavelength can be observed due to impurities in the sample, and it can be compared with that of standard raw material by also measuring the absorbance at specific wavelength. The impurities can be detected. Benzene appears as a common impurity in cyclohexane. It presents can be easily detected by its absorption at 255 nanometer. Another example in the chemical industry is the purity control in alcohol. Alcohol can be contaminated by benzene, which absorb light at 280 nanometer, whereas alcohol absorb at 210 nanometer. The measurement of the UV visible spectrum can easily tell if the sample is contaminated if an extra peak is present at 280 nanometers, so which we can see at the graph. There are some other applications of fixed wavelength in food and beverage industry that UV visible spectroscopy is used to monitor and improve product quality and consistency. Furthermore, the influence of packing material and stabilizers as well as chemical deterioration and degradation process can also be observed with this method. A typical application in this market segment is the check for the purity of olive oil, which enables a product to be classified as extra virgin, virgin, or simply olive oil. Standards are in place for the evaluation of olive oil based on absorbance characteristics of certain molecules in the UV visible spectrum. Olive oil contains about 98% triglycerides, the unsaturated fatty acid in the oil, are susceptible to breakdown and oxidation. The oxidation of free fatty acids causes the formation of peroxides. This leads to rancidity and degradation of the olive oil over time. Besides other parameters, this effect is evaluated by the conjugated dienes and triens of unsaturated fatty acids, which absorb in the range of 230 to 270 nanometer. The quality of oil is determined by observing the absorbance behavior of 1% solution in isopropanol between 200 and 400 nanometer. Elevated levels of absorbance in the spectral range from 200 to 400 nanometer indicate oxidized oil. So absorption measured in a 1% solution of extra virgin oil is blue and virgin oil is green, which is shown in the figure. So the second application of UV visible spectroscopy is structure elution of organic compounds. UV visible spectroscopy is useful in the structure elucidation of organic molecules, the presence or absence of unsaturation, the presence of heteroatoms, from the location of peaks and combination of peaks. It can be concluded that whether the compound is saturated or unsaturated, heteroatoms are present or not. We can check all these by UV visible spectroscopy. The next application is quantitative analysis, that determination of compound that absorb by UV irradiation. This determination is based on Lambert-Beer's law, which is as follows. Where E is extinction coefficient, C is concentration, and B is length of the cell. And I have explained this law in the next slides. So concentration and determination by quantification. The quantification or concentration determination of a substance by UV visible spectroscopy is based on Lambert-Beer law, which I have explained earlier. Which says that the absorbance of a solution is directly proportional to the concentration of the absorbing substance in the solution and the path length of the cuvette. Thus, for a fixed path length, UV visible spectroscopy can also be used to determine the concentration of the absorbing substance in a solution. However, it is necessary to know how much the absorbance changes with concentration. This can be taken from references such as tables of extinction coefficient, or more easily determined from a calibration curve. Next is calorimetric determination of sulfate, which is application in the field of chemistry. By using UV visible spectrometry. The basis of the calorimetric technique is direct relationship between the intensity of the color of a solution and the concentration of the colored component. A phosphate will readily react with aluminium molybdate in the presence of suitable reducing agents to form a blue colored complex, the intensity of which is directly proportional to the concentration of phosphate in the solution. The phosphate content of an unknown sample can be obtained by first plotting the absorbances of a series of standard solution against the corresponding concentration, thus giving a calibration curve. The unknown concentration of phosphate in the sample can then be determined from the graph. So this is the graphical representation of calorimetric determination of phosphate. Next, which I have already explained a bit, is Beer's law. When passing through a transparent cuvette filled with sample solution. The light intensity is attenuated proportionally to the sample concentration. In other words, a high concentrated sample solution will absorb more light. In addition, the attenuation is also proportional to the length of the cuvette. A longer cuvette will lead to a higher absorption of light, and the law states that A is equal to, say, epsilon naught D. This relationship is called Lambert-Beer's law, where the sample concentration C given in mole per liter or gram per milliliter respectively. The path length D of the cuvette is given in centimeter. The extension coefficient epsilon is a sample specific constant describing how much the sample is absorbing at a given wavelength in liter per centimeter per mole or milliliter per centimeter per gram respectively. So this is the graphical representation of Lambert-Beer's law, which is absorbance and which is between absorbance and concentration. So the next application of UV visible spectroscopy is qualitative analysis. So in this analysis, we can characterize those types of compound which absorb UV radiation. Identification is done by comparing the absorption spectrum with the spectra of known compound. UV absorption spectroscopy is generally used for characterizing aromatic compounds and aromatic olefins. The next application is dissociation constants of acids and bases. pH is equal to pKa plus log A over HA. From this above equation, which we see many times, the pKa value can be calculated if the ratio of A over HA is known at a particular pH. pH and the ratio of A over HA can be determined spectrometrically from the graph plotted between absorbance and wavelength at different pH values. So the next application is chemical kinetics. Kinetics of a reaction can also be studied by UV spectroscopy. The UV radiation is passed through the reaction cell and the absorbance of changes can be observed. The most widely encountered application of spectrometric rate measurement is to study enzymes. As we know, direct enzymes measurement and concentration of determination can be performed. But since this is very elaborative and chemicals are expensive, enzymes are rather analyzed for their catalytic properties and the reaction they catalyze. So, enzymatic determination of glucose in food products. In this example, a nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide coenzyme system in which the reduced form of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, abbreviated as NADH, shows the absorption maximum at 340 nanometer with an extinction coefficient of 622 mole per liter centimeter. The oxidized form of the molecules NAD plus does not absorb at this wavelength, but both NAD positive and NADH present at a peak absorbance of at 260 nanometer. The following figure shows the spectra of both compound with the NADH spectrum in and blue and the substrate NAD plus in red. So alkaline phosphatase enzyme activity, which comes under the chemical kinetics. These are the group of enzymes of the hydrolase class that split off a terminal phosphate group from an organic ester in alkaline solution. Their optimum pH is usually around pH 10, but this varies with the particular substrate and isoenzymes. These enzymes differ in amino acid sequence but catalyze the same chemical reaction and usually display different kinetic parameters of different regulatory properties. Alkaline phosphatases are available in almost every tissue in the body, and serum levels of these enzymes are of interest in diagnosis of several diseases. This application is mainly used in medical diagnostics. Oxidation of iodide by hydrogen peroxide. The determination of the reaction order of the reactant is achieved by performing a series of experiments in which the concentration of one of the reactants is varied, where As the concentration of the other reactants remained constant, the kinetics of the reaction was followed by measuring the intensity of the absorption band at 353 nanometer, that is related to the formation of cryiodide. The following figure shows the increase of absorbance at 353 nanometer as a function of time for four samples with increasing peroxide concentrations. The next application is quantitative pharmaceutical substances. Many drugs are either in the form of the raw material or in form of formulation. They can be assessed by making a suitable solution of the drug in a solvent and measuring the absorbance at specific wavelength. Diazepam tablet can be analyzed by 0.5% H2SO4 in methanol at the wavelength 284 nanometer. Concentration determination in health institutes. UV visible spectroscopy has effectively been used in medical science for the routine analysis of blood and urine sample. The spectral difference between healthy blood and diseased blood can easily be compared. Quantitation of blood hemoglobin has been a key diagnostic parameter for various diseases such as anemia, polycythemia, and dehydration. Hemoglobin is made of four peptide chain, each carrying a heme group. It is carried by the red blood cells and transport oxygen from the lungs to the peripheral tissue to maintain the viability of cells. In order to check the total hemoglobin content in the blood, the plasma is removed from the anticoagulated blood and the erythrocytes are suspended in isotonic sodium solution. Erythrocytosis is performed before the absorbance standard curve with freshly prepared hemoglobin. Molecular weight determination is also be done by UV visible spectroscopy. We can measure by preparing the suitable derivatives of these compounds. For example, if we want to determine the molecular weight of amine, then it is converted to amine picrate. The known concentration of amine picrate is dissolved in a liter of solution and its optical density is measured at lambda max 380 nanometer, and after the concentration of the solution in gram moles per liter can be calculated by using the formula which is given. C can be calculated using the above equation. The weight of amine picrate is known from C, and W molecular weight of amine picrate can be calculated, and the molecular weight of picrate can be calculated using the molecular weight of amine picrate. The next application is HPLC detector. A UV visible spectrophotometer may be used as detector for HPLC. The presence of an analyte gives a response which can be assumed to proportional to the concentration. For more accurate result, the instrument's response to the analyte is known should be compared with the response to a standard as in the case of calibration curve. So this is the visual representation of UV visible detection for HPLC. The last application which I'm going to discuss is scanning. In contrast to the fixed wavelength measurement, the spectral scanning measurement determines the absorbance or transmittance of a sample over a specified wavelength range or over the full spectrum range, typically from 190 to 1100 nanometers. Following the scan measurement, the most often applied analysis is the detection of peaks and valleys in the spectrum. A peak is where the absorbance reaches a maximum and a valley is where the absorbance is smallest between two peaks. The height and location of peaks and valleys is of interest as it gives an indication of the sample composition and purity. For example, from the location of peaks and combination of peaks, it can be concluded whether the compound is saturated or unsaturated. Furthermore, the identification of compound can be managed by comparing the spectrum to a known compound spectrum from our database. Scanning UV visible methods can be used for characterization aromatic compounds and aromatic halogens. So, scanning application of nicotinamide in food and beverage. As an example, the spectrum of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide is shown below. NAD is an important coenzyme found in all living cells, which I have explained earlier. Due to the presence of several aromatic rings in the adenine base, it absorbs light in the UV range. Running a scan analysis with a NAD sample shows that the maximum absorbance occurs at 260 nanometer. The absorbance fall value at the maximum in following example is one. So analysis of sunscreen in cosmetic industry can also be done by scanning the first formulation visualized in blue absorb most of UV radiation between 280 and 350 nanometer, which would indicate that the sunscreen formulation would be a stronger protector. In contrast, the second formulation depicted in green in the spectrum absorb only around 60% of the radiation between 280 and 350. The final sunscreen formulation can be measured directly using two UV transparent glass plates, between which a thin layer of the product is spread. The squeezed glass plates are placed on a solid sample holder to in the sample compartment prior to the spectrum measurement. So that's all about my presentation, and I hope it would be clear, and I try my best to give as many application of the UV visible spectroscopy, and that's all. Thank you, everyone.